And the reason I wanted to get into game shows, if I may digress for a moment, I became addicted to a show called Password. I'd get off the air from doing my radio show at KFWB every day and rush home at noon to watch Alan Ledden on Password. And it was such a simple concept, mm-hmm. and maybe that's why I liked it so much. It was simple, I could even play it. So I did some research, and I did my homework, and I found out that Alan Ludden came in 2 days a week, knocked out 10 shows, and the other 5 days he played golf. And I said, man, that's not a bad way to make a buck. So I went to Abrams Rubeloff, I went to Noel Rubeloff, yeah. God rest his soul, and I said, Noel, I like games. And I said, I've been watching Password. I'd love to go out on some auditions. And so he sent me on some auditions, and I think the second audition I went on was for a local show that was on KTLA as a local show called What's the Name of That Song? And I got the hosting job, and we did about 13 weeks, maybe 26 weeks locally. And it was one of those old deals where, you know, if it becomes successful locally, the deal was with NBC, they put it on daytime. Sure enough, we got good numbers, and it went on NBC. I think it was 1965. And they shortened the title to What's This Song for TV Guide purposes. And for that show, I became Wynn Martindale. It was only on for a year. Well, you know, the executives in New York who get paid the big bucks for making the big decisions, mm-hmm. somebody back in New York said, you know, Wink sounds a little juvenile. Why don't we knock that K off and we'll make him Wynn Martindale. And I remember so well, Steve Dunn, the great Steve Dunn, the late Steve Dunn, wonderful announcer, was the announcer on the show. And every time he would introduce me at the top of the show, and here's the star of our show, Wynn Martindale, I'd look around. For about 2 weeks, I'd look around, who is that?